so remarkable to have a composer who thinks about the characters in this way, who thinks about the story, who really sees and hears it in the way that I do too. I just imagine that Jonny Greenwood would be the best person for this film. It's just got such special dimensions. I can't imagine anybody other than him that would do it.
No, I mean, I always feel a little bit fraudulent that I'm quite rarely writing stuff directly to picture, and it's more sort of about the characters and the landscape, and, you know, which means, usually means writing a lot more music than is needed, but it also means I feel a lot freer to just sort of sit and write. I remember getting the early footage of cattle and the mountains, and it's so beautiful. And that was inspiring for the music, just seeing those sort of images.
And I've never seen a composer work like that in such a deliberate, clear way.
This specific film has been particularly interesting because of the way Jonny recorded a lot of it himself and layered up a single instrument himself over time.
There's no click tracks in any of the stuff. Tuned all the strings to C, then C sharp, then D, and just spent days recording hundreds of cellos and violas to make it sound like an orchestra playing.
There are loads of standout moments of music in this film, like the finger-picking cello stuff is really original. Never really heard anything like that before. I think live music to film is a really exciting medium because it shines a new light on the music and the relationship between the music and the picture itself.
It is not to be alone.
Honestly, I find that generally all film music is pretty great. I'm surprised how often I'm watching a sort of film that you don't think much attention has been placed to the score. And it's more often than not, there's some really interesting ideas and lots of great stuff being done.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe to the Netflix Film Club channel to get our latest exclusive videos. Plus, hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.